Sometimes you have a job, but you don't really have tools to do it very quickly. So I don't have a chainsaw, but I wanted to do some ripping off my green logs I just got. What I had was a crosscut saw. So crosscut for greenwood, I think it's around the 2 ppi saw, which is really designed for crosscutting, but I decided to try how well it's gonna work for ripping. And surprisingly, it worked reasonably well. It wasn't too fast, as fast as a kind of maybe much bigger teeth saws, and probably not as good as a really rip saw, because kind of the teeth are different and I'm trying to do different stuff. But it actually was working quite well. So as you can see, I was progressing reasonably fast. I mean, it's still a lot of effort to actually do this job. But I was progressing quite rapidly and eventually did the job. What I want to else emphasize in this video is I also don't have a saw bench of any kind. I just have a regular bench, and I wanted to secure this log somewhere, somehow. So I basically invented a saw bench using these two chairs. I have a small thing to secure legs of the of the chairs. So put the log on top of them and just start playing with the saw, basically. But it was fun, as you can see on the video. It's a lot of effort. I think it took me more than an hour, and I had to stop a couple of times to actually to have some rest, some water. Yeah, but I did the job eventually, as you will see, and it was a lot of fun. I think the ripping boards by hand, people use the so-called pit saw, and the actual pit, you can look it up in a few videos on YouTube. I think there's very good videos of that. And I think by inventing this two chairs and actually standing on top of them, so this is actually somehow resemble how the pit sawing actually progresses. Of course, they use much different saws. They're much longer and actually operated on both sides. So it's kind of operator on the top, and I think the helper on the bottom. So I think basically it's both kind of pulling and pushing the saw that works in both directions, and also seeing and correcting the potentially correcting the direction of the saw as you go along the cut. I didn't have that. I was just by myself playing with wood, so I was just kind of trying to do whatever I can. My saw wasn't long enough to do kind of effective ripping across, so the length of my saw I think was maybe two times the width of my cut, so it was a little bit shorter than it should be for this type of job. Maybe I think it would be a little bit more efficiently if it was like three times longer, but it worked. It was a lot of effort. I was sweating at the end of the job, but I think I liked the end result.